I have found that one of the hardest times for patients is after a miscarriage, figuring out what to do next and how to recover from it. Keep watching so you can learn my suggestions. Hi, I'm Dr. Marc, Sklar, fertility expert, and welcome to Fertility TV. This is your YouTube channel dedicated to empowering your fertility. I've been helping couples from all over the world get pregnant for over 17 years with my virtual consultations and online fertility programs. If you're trying to get pregnant, subscribe and hit the bell so I can help you too. And there's really no harder time than after a miscarriage. There's so much emotion, so much sadness and disappointment that comes with it. My heart goes out to all of you who have ever had to deal with a miscarriage. But there are ways to move forward afterwards, and I'm gonna give you a few of my tips right now. The first one is grieve. I think it's really important for us to just take some time to grieve. Now, some of you might do that quicker than others. Some of you might need longer time. But I think it's really important that we all just take a moment, understand what you just went through, what your body went through, and the loss you just went through, because it is a loss. And then from there, you can start to recover and move forward and start to ask questions and kind of make different plans. But I do think it's important to grieve. So take a couple of days or a couple of weeks, whatever it is that you need, and recover from this loss. Second, let's search for answers. Most of you who've had a miscarriage, one or more, probably haven't had additional testing. So let's have some additional tests done so that we can start to get more answers, so that we know how to move forward, so that this doesn't happen again. Some of the places that I like to start when I'm looking for answers and tests after a miscarriage is looking at autoimmune disorders and blood clotting factors. These are the two most common things that can lead to a miscarriage. The other ones are genetic issues, so you can do some genetic testing, or chance. The reality is one in four, maybe it's a little bit higher, women have a miscarriage. So it's not that it's uncommon, but it doesn't mean that we've got to just be accepting of it and say, oh, this is never gonna happen again. Pretty much the rule of thumb is after three, and recently they just switched it to two, after two miscarriages, your OB should start to want to do some testing. But I find that's not always the case, that it takes them longer. So I never even like to see one miscarriage. So is there a chance that nothing's really wrong after one miscarriage? Sure. Does it mean that you don't have to do anything to search further? No. I mean, certainly if you don't want to search any further, that's your prerogative. But for my patients, I always like to start digging a little bit. Maybe not a full in-depth miscarriage panel, but I'd like to start to peel the layers to get some more answers. And then number three, give yourself some time to prepare. So typically after a miscarriage, we find out, hopefully by doing some additional tests, we find out that there's some answers and there's a reason why this is happening. We need time to deal with those things. We can't just jump into getting pregnant once again. So my suggestion is take some time to prepare and deal with this so this doesn't happen again. The best time to treat a miscarriage is before you get pregnant, not during, not once you get pregnant. So I like to be proactive about that and make a treatment plan to be successful before, then afterwards we can start to try again and get pregnant. And then last, my fourth recommendation is make sure you get your partner or your husband tested. This is often one that's ignored, often one that's missed during a miscarriage, because most people don't think that poor sperm quality can be a reason for miscarriage, but it can. So please make sure they get tested. If they haven't, have them do it. If they have already been tested, then maybe you've got to go a little bit deeper and test a little bit further with what's called a DNA fragmentation test. But those are my tips. So the first one is make sure you grieve. The next one is search for more answers. Take time to prepare yourself is number three. And four is get your partner tested. If you've got more questions about your fertility or your miscarriage, you don't know where to go or what tests to run, then feel free to reach out to me. I work with patients one-on-one from all over the world, and you can work with me too. Just click right here to learn how to do that, or click on the link below. I'll see you in my next video. If you found this video helpful, there are three things I need you to do right now. Number one, like this video and leave a comment below letting me know what other videos you want me to cover in future videos that I record. Number two, subscribe to Fertility TV to get the best tips on how to get pregnant naturally. And number three, take the fertility quiz so you can find out what your fertility score is. It's a simple process to figure out what areas of your reproductive health are not quite right and what to do about it.